Today, we're diving into an important topic that concerns many men over 50, the PSA test. As men age, prioritizing their health becomes increasingly crucial, and the PSA test plays a pivotal role in monitoring prostate health. By examining your PSA levels, you can gain insights into potential prostate issues and assess the risk of prostate cancer. Today, we'll dive into why the PSA test matters, how to interpret it, and its importance for men's well-being. Remember, if you enjoy our video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. 1. What is the PSA test? The PSA test is a blood test that measures the level of prostate-specific antigen in your blood. PSA is a protein produced by both normal cells in the prostate and prostate cancer cells. It is natural to have a small amount of PSA in your blood, and as you age and your prostate gland enlarges, the PSA levels tend to rise slightly. This test, approved by the FDA in 1986, is commonly included in routine blood work during annual exams. 2. Understanding PSA levels. When the PSA test became a part of routine blood work for men over 50, it increased the chances of detecting prostate cancer. However, it's important to note that an elevated PSA reading doesn't automatically mean you have cancer. The normal range is considered to be from 0 to 4 nanograms per milliliter of blood, but it's common for older men to exceed this upper limit. Anything that increases the prostate size may also increase your PSA levels, but other factors should be considered too. 3. Medications. Certain medications may modulate the rate of PSA produced by the prostate. Some of them are prescribed for BPH, as in finasteride. In this case, finasteride reduces PSA levels. As good as this may appear, it sometimes hides high-grade cancer. Thus, your urologist may need to double your current PSA levels if you're under this medication. 4. Urinary infections. Luckily, they are not very common in males. However, if you have a urinary tract infection, PSA levels can be skewed. Thus, it is sometimes recommended to run a urine test along with a PSA test to rule out infections. Similar to prostatitis, they cause inflammation and make the prostate release more PSA to the blood. 5. Sexual activity. PSA levels are increased after ejaculation. The effect usually goes away after 24 hours and it is minimal. Still, it is recommended to abstain from sex 24 hours before a PSA test. 6. Pressure upon the prostate gland. Any type of pressure upon the prostate gland may increase serum PSA levels. For example, riding a bike for a long time or having a digital prostate examination. If you have any of these factors, it is recommended to ask your doctor before performing a PSA test. Chances are you will need to do it all over again if the results are skewed. It's also wise to maintain your own records of PSA testing over the years. By comparing fluctuations with prior readings, you can evaluate the significance of a single elevated PSA result. This becomes particularly valuable for older men with a history of an enlarged prostate. A consistent slow increase over several years in the absence of significant changes can provide important information to your healthcare provider. The pros and cons of PSA screening. While PSA screening can be valuable in detecting aggressive prostate cancer early, it's essential to be aware of its limitations and potential harms. False positive results can lead to unnecessary biopsies and treatments, particularly for older men. Biopsies carry their own set of risks and complications, including infections and other side effects. Remember, an elevated PSA level doesn't necessarily indicate prostate cancer. It's crucial to view an initial diagnosis as valuable information to guide your next steps, rather than an immediate call for aggressive treatment. By discussing the potential benefits and harms of screening with your healthcare provider, you can make informed decisions tailored to your individual circumstances. When it comes to prostate cancer screening and raising awareness, PSA testing has an important role. A raised PSA level can be a sign of a problem, and a PSA blood test can help diagnose that problem. However, while the test has its benefits, it's also important to remember that it is not always a reliable indicator and should be followed by other tests, including a rectal exam and multiparametric MRI. Enjoyed our video? Then please like, subscribe, and help us get to 100,000 subscribers. Lifestyle changes are still the most effective way to maintain a healthy prostate and lower your PSA levels. If you already have any prostate condition, you should get immediate treatment to avoid disease progression. Natural antioxidants and supplements are also useful in lowering your PSA levels and maintaining a healthy prostate.